Mr. Lang and Murasaki present Sonic Utopia.
Now loading.
It's loading.
Oh shit, here we go. Green Hill Zone. All right. Hi everybody. My name is Titus Malvolio, and I'm here today playing Sonic Utopia. I would if the camera was actually working. Hold on. Fuck. Hang on a second. I'll fix this. I'm fixing this right fucking now. I'm fixing it. It's fixed. Fuck. No, it's not. Oh my god. Hang on. Utopia demo. Yes. Input. Oh my god. What's going on? Y'all good? All right, let's play. Okay.
Take two.
Sonic Utopia!
Early demo, in fact. Green Hill Zone. What's going on, guys? Are you fucking kidding me? God damn it. Hang on. I'm fixing this again. It's only natural, right? Just gotta fix it. Uninvert. Right? Did that fix it? Why is the camera being all stupid? This is not an accurate representation of this game's quality, I assure you. I'm just fucking inept right now at fixing my camera. Look at him. Just look at how beautiful he is. I'm gonna fix this. Alright, hang on a second. Take two. I'm fixing this shit. This is not going at all like I planned. Fuck. Ah! Maybe this'll work? Hopefully it'll work? I don't know. I'm pretty hardened at this point. I don't think anything can faze me. It's still not working. Give me a break. Give me a break, son! Alright, here's the deal. We're gonna try this one more time. I'm gonna make this work. I'm gonna make this right, actually. We're gonna fucking play Sonic Utopia, even if it kills me. If this doesn't work, I may actually kill myself.
Take three, Mr. Lang and Murasaki present Sonic Utopia!
I would say more accurately, if this doesn't work, then I'm just gonna, plug the controller in instead of trying to use the goddamn Bluetooth. Okay.
All right. Okay. Why is the, is it because I'm trying to record it? I don't fucking know anymore, dudes. I just don't. This camera is unresponsive. Something is wrong. I'm venturing to guess that everything is wrong. You're wrong, I'm wrong, it's all wrong. All of it.
This is my life. This is my corner. It's my life and my corner.
I gotta undo the Bluetooth. Undo the Bluetooth, yes. Undo it. Undo.
My PC is a piece of shit.
One is the loneliest number that you'll ever do. Two can be as bad as one is the loneliest number since the number one. Ugh. This smug motherfucker. What? Why is it working now? What? I'm gonna have a long, hard talk with this when we get home, Sonic.
Take four. Mr. Lang, I'm here to present Sonic Utopia.
Oh, the suspense is killing me. Okay. I'm dying. Green Hill Zone. We're good? Oh, we're good. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woohoo!
Okay. Episode start.
Hello, guys. My name is Titus Malvolio, and I am going to show off Sonic Utopia today. This is a 3D fan game. You saw the names of the developers when the game booted up a bajillion times because I'm inept at
control options, and I couldn't figure out how to optimize my controller for this, but I played this a little bit yesterday, and I really wanted to fucking record it and show it off, because this game, this little teeny fan game, and I guess they're gonna make it into a full game later, I don't know how soon, probably not for a while, because this is actually pretty ambitious. This is the most ambitious Sonic fan game I've probably ever seen or heard about. But the thing about this game is that it has so much potential. Like, this is like the crux of what a 3D open world Sonic game could be. If Sega took this the guy who made this game and hired him, and they made a game like this, I think with a little bit of polish, like, on the visuals, like, the controls are fucking perfect. Like, this is how I have always wanted a 3D Sonic to control. And obviously, it looks a little rough around the edges. But that's totally okay. Fuck it. Hang on a second. Jiminy Christmas, fucking everything is just fucking up my recording today. It's fine. I'll just cut it out. It's fine. All right. We good? We good. Okay. So the thing about this game is that... Oh, God. Excuse me. I'm sorry. I'm running away now. Is that, like, this is, like, completely open world. Like, this is what an open world 3D Sonic could be. And that's fucking awesome, man. Like, look at it. It's so cool. Like, there's stuff underwater. In this one stage in the demo, there's secrets you can find. Like, this is like a whole playground. And the controls are so tight, and there's a bunch of different branching pathways, and like this. When I played this last night, I didn't go this way. Like, this is the first time I'm seeing this particular pathway. So it's so cool that I'm seeing new things every single time I boot this up. And that's how 3D Sonics should be, in my personal opinion. I mean, I like Generations as much as the next guy. Don't get me wrong. Generations is my absolute favorite 3D Sonic. But this game, this is how I always imagined the 2D Sonics would feel like in 3D. I have never in my life seen this area. I don't know what this area is. It looks unfinished. but it just, like, I don't know, it drives the point home. There's so many different things to discover, and whenever this fan game like completely comes into fruition, there's gonna be a lot of shit like this to explore. And I think with a production budget, like, this game could be so awesome. I've never had this much fun with a 3D Sonic since Generations. But, like, in such a completely unique way from Generations. The controls, like I said before, they're, like, super tight. Like, you can move Sonic, like, fluidly. He goes... The way he picks up speed is, like, by momentum. So he gets faster when you go down slopes. And that's, you know, that's how it should be, in my personal opinion. But he had... What the fuck? See, this shit is crazy. All of a sudden, I'm in this, like, underground cavern, and all of a sudden, I'm just back in Green Hill. Like, ugh. I don't even know where I am, but that's so cool that I don't. It's so cool that this world is so big and so open that, I mean, just look at it. Look at it. Everything you see, almost damn near everything you see on the screen right now, you can just fucking run over there and check it out. Like, it's... I can never stop, like, fanboying about this game. About this project, I mean. This is not a full game right now. Right now, it's just a project. And an early demo. And this is a very raw version of... But I really wanted to show this off because I think this is such a cool project, and I'm such a huge Sonic fan, and it makes me so happy just to see, like, fans making shit like this. And it's doubly cool that Sonic Team is, like, on record cool with people making games like this. And they've fucking hired fan game makers before. Like, what's his face? The guy who's making... Or guy who's, like, I don't know, executive producing Sonic Mania? Christian Whitehead? Like, wasn't he originally a fan game maker, and now he's like making an official Sonic game, like in that style, in the Sega Saturn style. Like, that's fucking crazy. Or Saturn. Did I say Saturn? I meant to say like Genesis. Or I don't know. I had a Nintendo when I was growing up. My cousins had the Sega, so I don't remember exactly what style it is, but you know what I mean. Like, it's more like Sega CD style, actually, now that I think about it. But anyway, I'm talking about Utopia right now. Sonic Utopia is super cool, and with all these slopes, and there's just so many things to explore, and there's a dash mechanic like this. Like, you charge up your dash, and then boom! He goes flying. And he also has his spin ball move. You crouch down, and then hit the button, and let it go! So many different, like, cool things. Cool concepts for this game specifically, and it looks like I already got to the end of the stage accidentally. I guess that that place, that underground cavern that I explored earlier, was, I guess, a bit of a shortcut, because I remember it being a lot longer than this. I'm not gonna hit that yet. There's a couple things I want to go check out. So I'm gonna run over here. There's a place that I found yesterday that I guess is a huge secret. And maybe it's not a huge secret, but you know what? Actually, I'm gonna hit the flag, and then I'm gonna restart the demo. But this is so cool that the end of the stage is fuck. I didn't mean to do that. Okay, so I'm gonna stop, and I'm gonna spin really hard, and then I'm gonna blast off. That wasn't that fast. I'm sorry. Anyway, so like the 2D Sonics, you hit the flag, and then you just keep running, and that's. It's a huge throwback to, you know, like Sonic 2, Sonic 3, Sonic 1, like all those Genesis Sonics with the signpost flag. It's not a flag, it's a signpost, right? Anyway, I'm going to boot this up one more time, and I wasn't going to play this for very long. I just kind of wanted to show it off if anyone hasn't seen it. I know there's like a bajillion YouTube videos, and I'm probably lowest in the barrel when it comes to... the YouTube scene, like, you know, I don't have that many subs, but I, you know, I'm working on it. I'm trying. See, this is me trying. I'm trying so hard right now. Okay. So instead of going left like I did, and I found that area, I'm gonna go right. There's a ton of different branching pathways in this one Green Hill Zone alone. And it's such a cool representation of Green Hill Zone, by the way. Like, this is how... I'm gonna sound like a broken record. This is how 3D Sonics should be. Like, look at how the ground moves. You see all, like, the Green Hill Zone-ish textures. But when you're running fast and you see the textures, it's a good indication of how fucking fast you're running. And the controls are so tight. Like, the big problem with, like, the official 3D Sonics... And they fixed it a little bit in Generations and in Sonic Colors, I believe. But the biggest problem was that you're going, like, so fast that it's really tough to kind of gauge your surroundings. And I mean, I suppose that's the point, in a sense, where you're, you know, you're playing a 3D Sonic, and you're going super fast, and you're using the boost mechanics, and the idea is to play the stages over and over and over again until they become muscle memory. And so you like know where all the obstacles are, and you just like you fucking bolt through them, and you get your S ranks and blah 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 blah, and you know, whatever. And that's cool, but that's also a really linear way to go about it, and a lot of people don't like that. And I'm not saying I hate that, because obviously I already told you guys in the beginning of the video, or well, maybe middle of the video, that Generations is in fact my personal favorite 3D Sonic. I never played Colors, mind you. I don't know why. Colors just kind of passed me by. I should check that out sometime, but... Generations is my favorite 3D Sonic. I think that is the best way, in this era, I guess you can say it, to handle Sonic in 3D. And, you know, a lot of other people, you know, agree with me. There's a reason why Generations was, like, the highest rated 3D Sonic in, like, you know, in years. I could be wrong about that. Colors could have been rated pretty high, too, but, you know, But just the boost modern Sonic is just the way to go. It has been for the last few years. And it seems like that mechanic is coming back for Project 2017. Which is fine. I mean, as long as they... Oh, fuck, I can't find the spring to get out of here. I'm gonna die. This is me dying. But yeah, no, Project 2017 is coming out, obviously, next year. And in the trailer, the reveal trailer... I died! Yay! In the reveal trailer for that, you can see both modern and classic Sonic using their boosts, which is probably like an obvious indication that the boost mechanic probably is coming back, and I don't mind that. I really want them to take the formula from Generations if that's what they're going to do. I mean, obviously, we don't know that yet, and I want them to kind of like revamp it, I guess, in a sense. And I know that that's possible, obviously. It's what was interesting to me about that reveal was that... Oh, fuck, I can't get on the fucking spring! Get on it! Okay. What was interesting to me about that reveal in particular was that you saw classic Sonic using the boost as well. I'm gonna die! I didn't die! Haha, bitches! You saw classic Sonic using the boost mechanic as well, which was really strange to me. Because he doesn't boost in Generations. You know, it was the classic stages and it was the modern stages. And the modern stages is what used the boost mechanic. Classic Sonic using the boost in that trailer was strange to me because it says to me, my mouse is on the screen, I don't know how long it's been there, I'm just gonna move that. What was I saying? That says to me that in Project 2017, if they use the Generations structure, I guess, that they're going to change it up. And maybe, just maybe, like we're doing here in Utopia, Classic Sonic is also going to be playable in 3D in like the modern style, and he's going to be able to use Boost. And maybe vice versa. So, like, that's pretty cool. Like, I hope they really go that route. I'm skipping past this area without even talking about it. So I'm just gonna go back. I'm gonna go back real quick. Alright, just hang on a second. So this is the secret area that I mentioned earlier in this demo. And maybe, it's a branching path, but it's also kind of secret because there are obviously tons of different ways you can get to the end of the stage. But this way was a little bit weird to me because you fall down this water. And then you see all these, like, symbols and signs on the wall. And you're like, oh, I wonder what that is. I'm gonna go check this area out. So you go in here, and you go up here, and then boom, like a labyrinth cavern just out of nowhere in Green Hill Zone. So maybe this isn't actually in Green Hill Zone in the full game whenever it releases, which I hope doesn't take too long, but I mean, fuck, I didn't mean to pause. I hope it doesn't take too long, but it probably will if there's only like two people working on it. But like, this is such an ambitious fan project, and it's so great, and it's worth showing off, and it's worth playing too. I'll link it down in the description. I'll link the demo Dropbox. But the last time I looked at the Dropbox for this, the Dropbox link, it was like it had like too much traffic or some shit, so it wasn't working. So maybe it's working by now. But that's just it, like, so much traffic that you can't even, like, fucking download the demo. That's how much hype that this little fan project is gathering, which is so cool to me. And Sonic Team is, like, A-okay with fan projects, and that's so cool to me as well. And, like, because they're not going to take this shit down. They're not like, some other developers I'm not going to name. Yeah, so, and this one little demo just, like, has a bunch of secrets. It's basically a playground. It's a playground to demonstrate the potential of like how 3D Sonics could be. And I know I've already said that, but anyway, so that was a little labyrinth secret, which might be a little taste of what's to come in the full game. So there might be like a whole stage that's like dedicated to that backdrop, which is cool. I like that. And I think I want to say they'll probably use a bunch of zones from Passana games as inspiration, which is totally fine. Like, I love this. This is awesome. This is such a cool imaginative Green Hill Zone. There's another mechanic in this that I'm demonstrating right now, is that Sonic, when he goes down hills, he picks up momentum, and that's how he picks up speed. So you saw his animation change just a little bit when he was going downhill. Like the spinny legs got bigger. Yeah, that's what this is. Woohoo! Oh my god, this game is so fun. Oh, so I'm playing with a PS4 controller. I don't know if if the button mapping is the same for the Xbox. It probably is. I'm mashing the X button right now, and it's making him do like this flutter. So it makes this kind of broken, and I wonder if they'll fix this later on. They probably will. I don't think they imagined this being part of the platforming. Or maybe they did, I don't know. I mean, it's cool. I like that you can just basically float down elsewhere to get to a platform that might be in the distance. So, I don't know, maybe it was intentional, but I'm gonna try to float over here. I'm gonna get on this platform. Haha! I love this game. It's so cool, and I want more. Like, after I played this for the first time, I was like, I need more. I need more of this. Like, am I the only one? I hope not. I think I'm gonna hit the signpost. Yep, I hit the signpost. I was actually hitting the signpost. So that's Sonic Utopia in a nutshell. Not much to talk about other than the fact that the controls are really nice. The visuals are pretty nice too. I imagine that after this gets polished, it specifies that it's an early demo. So, I mean, some fan games take like upwards of like years to come out, so this might still have a while yet. Part of me thinks that this might not even drop until after Project 2017, but I mean, who knows? I mean, it really depends on how big they decide to make it. But yeah, so that's Sonic Utopia. This is classic Sonic. He's a dashing young gentleman, and the character model looks pretty good too. For what this is, for like probably zero budget, I doubt they really put much money into this. This game was made with Unity. So like, I don't know. It's really nice fan project. Everyone's talking about it. Everyone's raving about it. I'm raving about it, and I cannot wait until the full game releases. So yeah, this is Titus Malvolio, drowning underwater. Later.
Rolling around at the speed of sound. Got one place to go. Gotta follow my rainbow. Don't think this is meant to happen. I'm just gonna throw that out there.
I turned his shoes into jetpacks. I'm sorry, Sonic. It was my fault. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Just don't hate me. Just don't hate me for this. Just don't hate me. Don't hate me. Don't hate me. Please. Please. Oh no. Oh no. What did I do?
I broke it. It's broken.
Welp. Later. Oh, it's not broken anymore. We're good.